Hi everyone and welcome back. So what I'm going to do in the next coming videos, we are going to take a look on small examples, and then we will take a look on simple applications, like we can write a simple single page application in React, which is having the features of routing, which is having the features of React Redux, and having an access to the APIs using use effect, all the different kind of hooks that we will test. But before that, I wanted to baseline some basic concepts, okay? Like how this testing library React, testing library DOM provides all different methods and how we can test them, okay? So we have seen these methods, get by text. You wanted to you have rendered a component which is having text field, image, label, HTML forms and all those things. How you can inspect and get HTML elements? So these are the different methods: get by role, get by label text, get by placeholder text, get by alt text, get by display value, and get by title. And what all these does? Get by label text, you can get any element with attribute value label. Get by placeholder, you can get it by using placeholder attribute in the input text field, text area and all. Okay, so based on that, the first example. Here you can see I have an image and I have a link anchor tag, and here you can see in this anchor tag and in this image tag I have alt attribute, so I can just use different methods which are provided by React testing library to get this image element and get this link element. Okay, how we do it? So this is our React component and I wanted to do the testing for this. There are different methods. So screen.getByText, right? GetByText means, if you see this method, here we have GetByText, find the element by its text content, right? So learn React. Where do you see the learn React when the component is rendered? Okay, I have learned React here, the exact match, okay? So I can get this link element from this screen attribute, screen APIs. Similarly, there are other APIs are also available. I will show you all. So instead of this get alt by text and all, what all other methods are there? So you can see get all by alt text is going to give you the array where the alt attribute is matching in all the image tags. Get all by label text, get all by role attribute, you see HTML4 role attribute is there in the forms and all. Get all by text, right? Get all by text means, okay, let's say you have multiple anchor elements, which is having the text content as learn React. Then you can get all. Get all by title, get by alternate text, these are the single values, right? So it is providing all the APIs to give you the array matching with that element, or it will give you the single element like get by title, get by text, get by test ID, which we have already used, get by role, get by label text. Here we are using get by alt text. That means in our JSX, we have alt tag for this particular image. Let's see, I have another image tag. And I'm putting it as a logo one, right? There are two image tags. So what I can do simply is, okay, for this image element one, I'm getting it like this. And for logo one, I'm going to get another element, image element one. And I can just check that this image element is also available in the document or not. Image element one, right? So this is my test case. What I'm just checking is, once this component is rendered, whatever I'm rendering contains the actual parts like images, the link element, the text field, the HTML form. That means my component is rendered in the expected way. And this is our React testing library, all the APIs, right? Similarly, we have seen the previous videos where we have seen all those things. Okay, let me see what is the problem here. Renders element, okay, so this is what it is rendering, logo one, this is screen.debug, okay, what it is doing, found multiple element with alt text logo, okay, yes, this is the thing, because here it is checking the logo, right? So if I change this to something else, let's say something, then it's not now logo. I'll just change it to something and it works, because it founds two elements with the same alt tag. Then we are just doing a single element rendering, right? It will just give us the warning, okay, for this particular match I found two elements, are you aware of it, all these things. Okay, now it will pass. Now another thing is we have like all these set of APIs, right, which I have shown you. Unable to find element with alt text logo, this was I think previous error. Get by alt text something, why it is reporting this, let's see. Didn't I save this? Class name map logo. I mean, this should work. There is nothing for link element, image element one. Okay. Now we will take a look on another spec, a simple another example, and what this example is doing. Here we can also inspect a particular button. Okay. Let's say I have this component. Now everything is passing. It's just about saving the content. Okay. So I'm just using this use state hook. This is a theme, set theme, and I have just a button. Okay. What test case we can imagine here is, okay, let's say you have a button. First of all, the button should be in the DOM element, and you simulate the click event on this button. And when you are clicking onto this, we are changing the theme. You can see based on the theme, we are toggling the theme from light to dark, dark to light, and we are setting that theme as a next theme. So whenever you click onto this, the label of this button should be changed from light to dark, dark to light. Okay, this can be the test case we can simulate with this. Now, how can I get this button element from this label? Get by text, right? This is what we are doing. Screen.get by text current theme. Okay, so what it will give me? It will give me button element, a single button element, and I can simulate the click event. Now, we can write more test cases here. This is one button toggle, multiple click. Okay, multiple click means we got the button element and we triggered it twice. Let's say, okay, then what should be the theme right now? What should be the text content once you do the double click, right? For me, it should break. You did double click. So now the next theme would be something else, not exactly the dark. So we can see that in the output. Also, okay, it's running. So once you click once, then the theme will be initially theme is set to the light, right? Current theme light. Then the next time when you click onto it, it will become dark, right? So here we can see the failure. It should become dark, right? So current theme is light, this is what you are receiving, and dark is what you are asserting. So you can simply say, once you are doing a double click, it will become light. Okay, a simple test case. And here we are using the same set of APIs, get by text, get by label, all these different set of APIs which we have seen. Get by placeholder text, get by alternate text, get all. So these are single, these are going to give you the single elements, but you can replace these with a get all by text, get all by role, get all by label text, get all by alternate text, right? So these are testing libraries, screen APIs, which we can use, okay? Let's see more examples like this for the query elements, because these are nothing but accessing the DOM. If you see the basic DOM APIs, we use get element by ID, get element by tag name, and then there is a query selector all. Some are giving us the single element node, single HTML node. Some are giving us the array. So that depends on the use case, what we are using. Okay. Thanks everyone.